Keeping up with our motto, let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure. Here we are with a remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning, students.
A very warm welcome to the students of Thakur Vidya Mandir High School and Junior College, Standard 4th, Subject EVS 1, Lesson Number 10, Topic Clothes. Students, we all love to wear colorful, fancy and fashionable clothes. So today we are going to learn about it and how these clothes are manufactured and how they are long lasting, that is durable. Children, I am sure that you might have visited a tailor. What does a tailor do? Yes. He is stitching clothes for us. For stitching clothes, the tailor cuts the cloth. Students, if you might have ever visited a tailor, you are going to do this activity. You are going to take a piece of cut cloth that he does not need. What do you see at its edges, that is corners? You will see that fine threads are coming out of that cut piece of cloth. As you can see in these two pictures. Oh, what this little girl is doing? She's using something and looking at a cloth. Yes, she's using a special type of glass to find out the design or pattern of the cloth. Students, when we use this special glass that is called as magnifying glass, it shows us the different arrangements of the threads in the cloth. The threads are sometimes arranged in the vertical arrangement or in the horizontal or in the slant form. Let us learn about magnifying glass. This is the picture of a magnifying glass. Magnifying glasses are a kind of lens that is used to make objects appear larger. A small object or a tiny object can appear bigger and can be seen very, very clearly using a magnifying glasses. Cloth or fabric is made by intertwining threads together. Intertwining means combining or bringing together the threads. Intertwining threads together is called weaving. Long threads are woven together to make cloth. Cotton cloth is made from the threads of cotton wool on machine. Students, you can see in the picture how the spun of cotton thread is attached to the machine, and in the other picture you can see how the long threads are weaved in the machine. Students, with the help of this small activity, let us learn how the cotton threads are made. First, we will see. Take a wad of cotton wool, pull at it from either side to make it as long as possible. Lay it on your palm and pressing it with the other hand, roll it in one direction. Now we will see what happens. You will see that the wad of cotton gets twisted into a long wick. Students, in the fourth picture you can see how the cotton was taken and how when it was pressed on the palms, it became a long, thick, thread-like thing. And this wick is attached in the oil lamps so that it keeps burning for a longer time. Now, there are two types of wick. One, the long wicks, and in picture number 5, you can see the round wicks. Both these wicks are used for burning the lamps, oil lamps. And earlier, a spinning wheel was used to draw yarn from cotton. Spinning wheel means the charkha, as you can see in the picture on the left hand side. Nowadays, the same process is carried out on machines. Nowadays, people do not use this spinning wheel because it takes long time to make the thread. So nowadays, we all use machines to make the threads. Students, apart from cotton, we get cloth from jute also, as well as cotton too. Both these fibers are obtained from plants. They are natural source of fibers. From jute, you can make jute bags, doormats, and many other decorative articles are made from jute. The next is colorful fabrics, or you can say colorful clothes. These clothes are made with the help of cotton. Apart from cotton, there are other materials which is obtained or made. Let us see those. Clothes from things other than cotton. The first one is silk. Silkworm prepares silk thread, which can be obtained from its pupa. Wool. Wool can be obtained from the fur of sheep. Artificial fibers. Artificial fibers means these fibers are man-made. They are created or they are made in the machine. These fibers are man-made and used to make cloth. For example, rayon, terrylen, nylon, polyester, etc. Students, we have seen the various fibers that we get, but now we will see the methods to weave this cloth. The first method is with the help of needles. You might have seen your grannies or your mothers using these needles to make the sweaters and caps. The second one is hand loom. Machines run with the help of hands are called hand looms. Cotton and silk cloth are usually made on hand looms. As you can see in the picture, a person is sitting and running the machine with the help of his hand, and various color threads are attached in this machine. The next is power loom. Machines run with the help of electricity are called power looms. Many types of clothes are made on a large scale using power looms. Students, as these machines run on electricity, a large quantity of cloth is produced on these machines. And because of this, the production is also too much in bulk. Now it's time to learn how to clean the clothes. Students, when we are wearing clothes, we wash it regularly after the use. Why do we do that? Because it becomes very dirty after we use them due to various reasons. And to keep ourselves healthy, we wash our clothes regularly with soap and water. In order to take care of our health, we should wear clean clothes and should also keep them neat and tidy. Students, wearing clean, neat and tidy clothes is a good habit. Students, if we wear clean clothes, we look more smarter and brighter. Now, let us learn how to clean our clothes. We wash our clothes regularly, isn't it? Sometimes in washing machine or sometimes hand wash. We use plain soaps, detergent soaps and liquid soaps for washing our clothes. We can also use soap nuts. Soap nuts are also called as Rita, washing soda, Hinganbath and limestone to wash our clothes. These substances are natural ones. Students, all these natural materials were used in the earlier times, that is olden times. Nowadays, we do not use all these natural substances. We go for soap, detergent powder and liquid soaps. Students, whenever we are continuously wearing any type of clothes, it becomes faded or sometimes it gets torn. So let us learn today how to reuse these clothes. Clothes are durable. Durable means long lasting. Even if they become old, they can be reused. We can reuse the clothes in the following way. Giving these clothes to the needy and poor people. Children, if you feel that your clothes have become short or it is faded out or you don't like it anymore, so those clothes you can hand it over to the needy and poor children. Torn clothes can be made into small articles such as dishcloth, quilts, doormats, etc. Old cloth can be made into new cloth by taking its threads out. Threadbare cloths can be converted into pulp. Pulp can be used to make paper. This paper is used for making flowers and paper plates. Models can be made from cloth pulp. Students, now it's time to learn something very interesting. You might have seen this lady in your locality. Yes, you are right. She is the lady who is giving us new utensils, and in return, we have to give her old clothes. She is the woman buying old clothes in exchange of new utensils. We are supposed to name this lady. What she is called? She is called as Boharin. Boharin is the lady who buys old clothes in exchange of new utensils. And these old clothes are sent for recycling in the factories and changing it into a new clothes. Let us learn about the diversity in clothes. Students, have a glance at these pictures. In each picture, you can find people wearing different types of clothes. So, diversity in clothes means differences in the style of wearing different kinds of clothes. Different clothes are worn by different people living in different areas. Kids, we find diversity in clothes due to various reasons. Let us know it. The first reason is due to cultural and geographical differences, there is diversity in clothes and clothing styles. Due to climate, people select a particular fabric and a dress. Special clothes are worn during festivals, celebrations, special occasions, etc. In Maharashtra, majority of the people use cotton clothes. Children, the reason behind it is because the climate of Maharashtra is very hot and humid. And that is the reason why most of the people, majority means most, most of the people use cotton clothes. There is always change in the clothing and dressing pattern as per the time. Students, if you compare the dressing style of your mother when she was small or young, it will be totally different when it is compared to your style. So, it keeps on changing as per the time. And the last is, earlier people had different style of clothing. Each and every one of us are having a different style to put on the clothes. Students, we have completed all the points of this chapter. So, let us now summarize what we have learned in this chapter. We have learned that cloth is made from yarn. Yarn may be made from cotton, wool, silk, artificial fibers, etc. Clothes become dirty on being used. We must always wear clean clothes. Soaps or natural substances like Rita can be used for washing clothes. Old clothes should not be thrown away. They can be reused. We see diversity in clothing because of cultural and geographical differences. There is a difference in the types of clothing worn in earlier times and those worn today.